Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we're painting again. And as you can see, on the other angle, we have our scene that we're going to paint. We've got the car here, and then the big tree, and a bit of a road that goes off here. A bit of light there. We've got a nice darkness here. There's a couple of signs there to the public path. Bit of a fence. And we're going to do this quite loose. I've not done any drawing for this. I'm just going to paint it and have some fun with it. And let's just see what happens. Let's not worry. Let's move this here. Actually, I'll just show you this. I found this in amongst some of my older paintings. That's me practicing faces. And I'm going to use it to do this. So, all I need to do, which I've forgotten to, I just wanted to just give it a tape on the back. And there was already a bit there. I forgot that I did that. And also, I wanted to check how far the car comes out. So if I've got canvas space, maybe I could do it like that. Or could do it the opposite. For some reason I can copy better when it's that way round. Yeah, that does work out a bit better, doesn't it? So we'll have a go at painting this. Maybe we'll do a little bit of rough marks. We need to get this started and then once it's started, roughly. It's a rough business, this painting. Yeah, once it's got a rough marking. It's funny, I always feel like I'm starting to learn to paint when I pick up my brushes again. I'm like, oh, this is the first time I've ever painted again. How strange is that? I must have done I must have done hundreds of paintings. Hundreds. I'm still working at it. Maybe I won't use this marker. Maybe I'll just sort of sit back and just scrub this in and let's just see where this bit is. I say I'm not going to use the marker, then straight on it. It's about there. That's about where the car finishes. So I'm going to treat this car like anything else. And I'm just using a little bit of cadmium red and a little bit of ultramarine blue just to dull the red, just to get this started up. I'm going to scrub the colour on. So we start with a dull colour to get the shape, and then what we can do is lighten it. And of course, as always, we don't use that much paint to start with either. How big is that? So when you look at this car, It's a bit about there, I think. Yeah, if you squint your eyes, you can see, like, this red blob here is a big piece. The window's darker, and that red line there, that sort of goes like that. But just see it in the blob. Just a blob. Then once you've got the blob there, you can start refining the blob. You see what I mean? So the window bit is quite dark. I'm going to put the green in. There's a little bit of green in my colour. Something like that. Like that. Then you sort of look at the shape of that window. It goes down. Then we got tyres. We got the tyres. We can use this dark, actually. This is just a bit of red, and then blue, and then a bit of brown in it. Just really easy, really simple. Simple, simple, simple. And keep yourself well sat back. Don't think. Oh, I think I better sit forward. Because I can't really see. I want to keep sat back. There's a wheel there. Up there. Remember, we're quite rough with it. The mirror there. And then there's the other wheel there. About there. Got the shadow underneath, so we can turn that into a block. So we'll go with that. The card's finished. We're done. Brilliant. 10 points. Let's put this painting in the museums. Say, this is how Jason gets the feeling of a car. More like that, and then the number plate there. So it's not perfect. No one's saying it's perfect. But what we're trying to get is the illusion of a car in a very quick way, because we're going to start painting more. Because I don't like painting detail first, because I always make errors, and I'll need to be strict with myself to hold myself back. Hold myself back from details. So I might reveal a bit more of the picture. So we've got quite a bit of blue sky. We've got our palette of colours, which I'll go through now. So we've got some cadmium yellow ochre. ultramarine blue, burnt umber, cadmium red, sap green, titanium white. I've got homemade white. You see that? Homemade white. And the out of the tube white. You can see it's a lot thicker and a lot smoother out of the tube than it is hand ground. But I think I added some calcium carbonate in that. I think I did. Anyway, phthalo green. So that's our mixture. And when I did the dark colour, it's just a bit of red, a bit of brown, a bit of blue. Just mix it here, that's all. But for now, let's make a sky colour with some blue and white. Something like that. It's not far off. It's not going to be exact because I'm not going to bother putting anything else in it. I'm just going to go with that blue. I would say this is slightly warmer than the than that. How do I do it? There we go. Let's go there. Right. Let's get some blue in. This is a good test to see how good your paint is, look. When you go over the dark, if you can still see what's underneath, it means you've bought some cheap paints. For shame. For shame. Try not to paint on the I was just trying not to paint on my reference picture for now. Still using it, you see. I'll move it aside actually while I look at the whole picture. So we've got a big tree. Let's look at the overall shape of that tree. It's quite rounded, isn't it? Something like that. Rounded, and that goes here and here. I want it to be a bit lighter in here as well. A bit of white. White to dark. Dark to light. Boom. There we go. So we need it to be a bit lighter down here. And this goes to about there. Light, 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 light. Okay, that's a quick sky. And then let's, as you can see, kind of a cloud here. So let's get a bit, just throw in some white. And we can, my finger, you see that? I didn't even notice that. I was like, boom. It's because I wanted to do this with my finger. I don't really want a blue finger today. Just get a bit more of the white. Throw in a little bit of the pre-made paint in with my paint just to thicken it up a bit. Of clouds further there. Quite like that. A bit more there. Oh, I couldn't resist it, could I? Here we go. Just the leaning back. What we could do with now is really blocking in that big tree. Get some of that done. We'll leave that brush behind. Get rid of that. This brush had some green on it before, be alright. We'll put in our dark, let's move the reference. Just want to get this full shape in. Get some of this sap green, some of the brown. I want it to be warm, so red in it. Bit of the red, bit of the blue. Bit more of the green, I think. It's quite a nice dark, actually. It's very, very warm, just what I like. Right, so let's screw this on. Too much about getting this exact, actually. Sometimes I really want to get everything exact, but I'm not really that fussed about this one. I just want to get the basic idea. There's quite a dark area there. Dark in here. It's great the more you do, isn't it? And I like it. The more paint that I get on there, the better I like it. Something like that. Even when it's like the rough darks like this, just makes me feel good. So we've got like a block of this. This dark here. It's quite. Yeah, it goes to about there. So what I'm doing is I'm changing the flavour of the darks. If you notice, I just threw in some colour and threw in some other colour, and just wanted to change things, you see, just so my darks has a bit of variety in it, rather than it being all the same. About there. Okay, this bit here. Alright, because I know this comes out behind. I can change the flavour here and there, maybe make an area warmer. Dark, warmer. Or cooler. Warmer or cooler, doesn't matter. This kind of comes together in here. Tree there. more front on and some light on it. But yeah, we'll work that out. We'll work that out. What else have we got to do? Got some sky that goes down here. To be careful when you go into the dark. So I wiggled it into the dark, and then that's it. Wipe the brush, a bit of paper, back into the paint, and I can wiggle it in again. And then that'll do, I think. Trees all the way along here. Trees along here. Like I said, I don't have to be that strict on these bits. Tree there. Trees along there. Okay, now there's a bit of a... I'm going to grab... I just grabbed a little bit of phthalo green into my sky, and it mixes in with that brown and stuff, and it, the dirty green that it creates is not bad for the field behind. Field out there. There we go. You can see a few levels there. Charge that colour up a little bit more of the phthalo green. Yeah, it's a bit better. Just wipe my brush. Get a bit of this dark. Grabbing a bit of dark. A bit of dark. A bit of yellow ochre. I forgot to pick my palette up. Been using my palette like that all the way. Not really thinking about it, to be honest. See, you get into the zone when you're painting, you forget. So it's quite hard to teach and paint or film and paint and be good at it. Because I throw myself in there, I'm pretty much there. So I forget what I'm doing. Just remember I'm painting and just try to talk about it as much as I can. Just to give you an idea, really these aren't perfect videos for teaching, but they might help, and that's good if they do help. So I'm trying to add more education by doing more education onto my channel by doing live videos. I tried my internet out the other night to see if it worked. It seemed to work okay. And I thought, well, that seems to be all right, so that could give me an opportunity to teach a bit more on the painting side of things. That's not it's not just me painting. Then I can think about things a bit more, and then when people ask me questions, I can think about it and answer it as best I can. That's kind of the way I want this channel to go. I want it to go more on the education side of things, because there's people at home like myself that's not been to art school. Maybe they can't afford to go to art school. Maybe there is no art school near them. And maybe some of my information will help you out, because it does take a long time to learn art, and not all the information's there. So you have to either use trial and error. Wow, that's weird. Use trial and error, or which is what I do. Get this path in there. I'm using this just to get it started, and then I can do light on top. Mostly this is light over this side, so I'll use this mostly on this side, and then I can always use thicker colour for light. Stealing the old Dutch masters techniques, really. They would do something, well, they do something way better than this, but they would use techniques like that. They would use quite thin paint, almost probably their sketch, and let it show through. And then for other areas, like the lights, they would let's make a separation there. Yeah, for the lights, they would use a bit thicker paint. The paint would get thicker the lighter it gets. Just putting a bit of light here. Don't want to do too many strokes here because it disappears. There we go, that's better. That is better. You can actually see it. You can see it, which is what I wanted. I want it to be able to see it, yes. It's not bad, is it? It's not bad, not bad. Going to bring that up there, won't I? There we go, that'll do. Okay, so we're starting to block in more and more. Let's get this in here. Using a variety of push-up brush strokes and all sorts in this, just to give it a little bit of separation so it's not all the same. Too bad. not too bad a start. We need that sandy yellow colour of the ground next. I'm going to use yellow ochre in this mix. It's not bad. I might put a tiny bit of red in it just to warm it up. That can be our more white. Yeah, that's closer. This is our light side. Around here it's more sandy. So ochre-y. Just wanted to put my brushes down. I didn't want to be holding too many brushes. More the yellow ochre, just pure yellow ochre on the brush. And a little bit underneath. Yeah. Okay, I might throw some blue and brown stuff in this. Bit of red. Blue, I think. Just to make our light part of the road, that is. Just to make the light part of the road. And, blend that in. Can go over there like that. And that goes like that. And there's a bit of light hitting that there. That's quite good. Probably go a little bit lighter. Probably go a little bit lighter in this area. Thank you. Okay, that's quite a nice start. I think I might put in a bit of light that's up here. So I'm flying around this palette. Got this yellow here. Kind of goes green because it's got a bit of all sorts in it. That'll be nice for the light that hits there. Like that. Throw in a bit of the yellow ochre. Oh, this is the problem with cadmium red. I just threw some in. Look at it, just gone red. Get some light green, throw that in, there we go. Something a bit different there now. Yeah, just changes things a little bit in that light. It's a bit of a light on a tree. Too much. There we go. So I'll do for there. Oh, there's a bit more here as well. A bit more light there. There we go. Keep things simple. We're staying simple. So I've got a bit of this reddish green. It's quite nice. Put it on top of this. Do. There's some little hints of things. So I'm making a green. A white in it. That's quite nice. And more of the colour. Yeah, quite like that. We'll use that for the tree as well, I think. Nice. So I'll get a bit on it. I want some things here, but I want to keep some of that grass. I'm not even dark. I want to keep some grass. I want to keep some dark. So we'll put in a few little bits. Into the car. Well, that'll do. We need to start shaping that car. I might do this. Just touching the brush. It's still got paint on it. Part of the way up the brush. But if I touch it, you can get some different effects off that brush. Do it here, look. So you've got some paint still on it. But it's further up. All that difference there. Oh, so much difference. Okay. I'm Well, while we're doing this, I might put some... maybe we'll just use this brush for this as well. Just use this sort of technique and just pushing it. Don't want to get rid of all the dark, mind you. Quite a lot of dark on this side, so we just want we can do that. You can do this side of the brush, different sides of the brush. You can go with it like that. Some areas are still dark, some are light. You can use the brush flat like that. The whole thing and getting them shapes. Just sit back, have a look, see what you've got. Use this. Such a kind of a haphazard stroke, really, isn't it? You're just touching with the brush and letting what happens happen. Sitting back, having a look. It's looking quite nice. Put a few little separators in amongst there. There's a few little glimmers of light. Even in the darkest areas. Okay. More yellow on now because I want more, a bit more in here, and sort of a shape that goes like that. Got all that paint. Really loading it up. Sap green and white, yellow.
leave areas to break. I think I've moved up a bit too far this way. Oh, we can bring it across. Yeah, let's have a look at that. Throw a bit more red in it. Nearly fell off my chair. See, it's tricky. You lean back, sitting back, having a look, but you don't want to fall off your chair. Quite like that. I might throw in some really light spots in amongst it. Just throw some white in the colour mix, just to bring some of it out a bit. There's a yellow. Yeah, I kind of like that. Pull a few of these out. Need a bit of dark. Just areas that I've gone a bit overboard, I'll just take away again. Then I can kind of shape it to the way I want. I want a shape that way. And I can break it up a bit like that. I'm actually liking this. I'm liking this better than the photo, because the photo didn't quite work for me. Kind of my fault, because I was messing around with the photo on the computer and I kind of bodged it up. There we go, that's a bit nicer. Right, I like that. So now I think I'll start focusing on the car. Try and get this car to look better. And then we can look at the whole painting and then we can decide what we want to change, what we don't want to change. Whether we want a few blip, 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 blip. should we do? So it's raining outside at the moment. Raining. Don't get to enjoy the sunshine. There we go. There we go. So we can have a good look now at the car again. What we're going to need, I think, we'll need a dark and a light. I might use these two brushes as my dark and light, and then we'll see if we can get the look of this car. So I'm going to get some of this red, cad red. I'm going to try and clean this up. So we've got a shape that goes. I don't know why cars are so hard to paint. Well, they are for me anyway. Suppose I've not painted very many. In fact, I didn't remember painting any. Not like this. I used to shy away from painting stuff that I found difficult. That's not the way to get better, is it? Strange, that shouldn't be like that. Green. Just trying to get that colour. Yeah, sort of that. Sort of a almost phthalo green. That's not too bad, is it? That's not too bad so far. Let's come in. We have something that sort of resembles a car. I don't want to use too big a brush either, because if I do that, I know what will happen. It will start to look won't look right, basically. It'll look... It'll look too, I don't know, fake. if I had too much detail, it won't be the effect I'm after. That's what I'm trying to say. A bit of yellow. Let's get another brush. It's quite good fun when you sat back having a look, painting. I need a bit of white. There's a little bit of a bloop there. Might just indicate some of there. That top. It's very much a blue and white. Blue and white. Yeah, that's not bad. A nice little effect, and then we got that sticker. Quite good. I want some red for this. Bit of light under there. Something else I can do actually. I need a bit of colour for these. That's not too bad. To work on that dark a little bit. To go a bit darker there. And the body of the car. Needs to come over that wheel. Am I missing this? Not too bad, not too bad. a bit of a improvement on that. I put a little indication of a door handle there. Under part of the best not do too much detail actually. An indication of a car. An indication of a car. It's not too bad, is it? Not too bad. That's in the wrong place. That dot. It should be there. Well, there's an aerial as well. Might as well paint the aerial in. Why not? Paint that aerial in. There. Can you see that mirror? Soften that there. Something else I haven't done. Just wipe my brush. I need a bit of a number plate, a bit of yellow. Just put a bit of a number plate in. Yeah, kept it quite simple. That's quite a simple car. I quite like that. I think when you look at it, you think car. I think it will do. Now we need to start bringing up that ground that's around. The ground that's around. Okay. What I might do, what I could do with is some pure red just to finish that car off. Some pure red. Wipe my brush. Because at the moment, although it looks, you know, it's not bad, doesn't look too bad, it needs those fresh strokes of colour. do that with some nice fresh red. Nice strong cadmium red. Straight out the tube. Onto the small brush. And then some quick strokes. Nice fresh strokes like that. Just makes it a little bit something like that. I think that'll do. I don't want to go too much. Right, so we've got the car in, we've got fence in. Do we put the fence in? I'm not really sure if I want a fence in there. I quite like the way that looks. Do I want a gate? Soften in that area. Suppose I should have a bit of a gate. I quite like the walk through. Quite like that walk through bit. Maybe I will put that in. Some old posts. Sort of here and here, there, and there. That's the piece of wood that you walk across. I might put instead of a fence there, I might put some more, because it shows I don't really want a fence, to be honest. You can see some dark leaves and things here. Maybe you could see it. Bit of a path. But I'm thinking instead, maybe just a hedge. I think it does need a gate. It's sort of a light blue, isn't it? Oh, well, we can put a little... We can put an indication of a fence in there. Why not? Let's put it in anyway. So we've got shield. straight down. And you can kind of see it go through there. To the yellow ochre side. I've got a few fence posts coming out here as well. Leaves and things. And some darks back in there. Just sort of sit back, have a look. That's a little bit on the wavy side. Let's do that again, that top one. Perfect, is it? Hum, hum, hum. Yeah, it made it better. Maybe it made it a bit better. Yeah, that'll do. I don't want to spend a million hours on this picture. Ooh, that's quite good, actually. I just need to lighten up this fence a bit. I think that'll do. I think that's all right. Put a little bit of that there. And a little bit of greenery coming out. Yeah, I think that'll do. I think that'll do. I don't feel like I need to do anything else. I can't see anything else that I desperately need. I think I'm there. Maybe there's a touch of light. Higher. I think I'll go with that. Let's have a look at it on its own without this. That's not bad, actually. I think it needs... a touch more of this light in here. Okay, just sit back, have a look. Get a light there. That's not bad. I think that isn't too bad, actually. That's better. Yeah, quite like that. Quite happy with that. That's not too bad. I wonder if I should put a couple of birds in. Usually, when I'm over this area, I tend to see... well, you see all kinds, really. Yeah, I've seen a pheasant here before. And buzzards and all sorts. Actually, almost saw a buzzard. Well, I didn't... almost took a photo of a buzzard today. Almost. I might put a JB down here. I do like this painting. I might put little birds about there. Put a few in. I do see quite a lot. Blackbirds, pigeons, buzzards, sparrows, all sorts. You get all sorts there. Yeah, that'll do. That'll do. That's quite... it's quite a nice little painting, isn't it? I'm still thinking, oh, I could do this, I could do this, I could do this. But I shouldn't really, because I'll end up messing it up. So I'll leave it there. So thanks very much for watching this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it wasn't too stressful watching me paint a car. So thanks very much for watching. Maybe you want to give this one a try. Take a picture of it. Or maybe take one of your own. Or maybe change the car. Maybe you want a blue car in there. Or a yellow car. Or a white car. Want this to be a winter scene, you can do whatever you like. Your imagination, you can do all sorts. So thanks very much for watching this one, and I'll see you in another one. Cheers, bye.